WHTZ 100, 7:40 in the morning, 20 before 8 o'clock in the morning. It's a wet, rainy Monday. Don't forget the winner of the Bon Jovi Backstage Blowout Contest will be announced tonight with Jack the Whack after 7. Somebody for me.
How you doing, dude?
Not you, numbnut. 7:44 in the morning. 7:44, 16 before 8 o'clock. Michael Scott's headed in Ross, the boss, the Manila Gorilla, with the AccuZoo weather today.
Lots of rain on its high to 52 today. 43 right now on the Monday morning zoo.
And whatever you do, watch yourself, especially if you're driving a, like a Mazda, let's see, a Honda, a Toyota, a Nissan. A Subaru, maybe.
Watch out if you're driving those Japanese cars.
A Mitsubishi. I leave any out.
Nah, you got them all.
I think that's it.
Especially those Toyotas and those Hondas.
You better slow that car down. Don't come driving down here like you crazy.
I'm in the Northside Hospital, flat on my back. My legs are broken and my ribs are cracked. My front teeth are missing. I'm one big scar. Don't ever have a wreck in a Japanese car. Well, me and my buddy, we're out for a ride. We had a couple of honeys sitting by our side. We stopped at a red light, three cars back, when this guy behind us
you are, you're still not safe in a Japanese car. I know they're pretty and they'll take you far, but you're gonna get killed in a Japanese car. I love my Sony Walkman, my Hitachi TV, my Nikon camera, and my new CD. I time shift my viewing with my VCR, but I'll never buy another little Japanese car. There's not a song on the radio that I can't get with my new Nakamichi metal tape cassette. Yamaha built this great guitar, but I'll never buy another little Japanese car. Now I don't care how fat you are, you're still not safe in a Japanese car. I know they're pretty and they'll take you far, but you're gonna get killed in a Japanese car. Another sunny day. I want steel all around me and a heavy frame. These recycled beer cans crush and maim. What would have been a fender bender years ago has broke my nose, chopped off my toe. Planned obsolescence, that's all they are, and you're gonna get killed in a Japanese car. I'm in the Northside Hospital, flat on my back. My legs are broken and my ribs are cracked. My front teeth are missing, I'm one big scar. Don't ever have a wreck in a Japanese car. Yeah, well, me and my buddy, we're out for a ride. We had a couple of honeys sitting by our side.
You're still not safe in a Japanese car, buddy. Jumping John of the Oserettes at 747. Good morning, Z100. You think we forgot some?
Yeah, you forgot Hyundais and Yugos.
No, not Japanese.
I don't think so.
Oh, I don't care.
Those aren't Japanese cars.
Yeah, Yugo is Yugoslavian.
Hyundai is South Korean.
Yeah, I know, but you're still going to get killed here.
Beautiful.
Thank you for brightening our day today.
Uh-oh.
Bye-bye.
Bye. We saying that?
That's terrible.
Beautiful. Beautiful. I'll tell you what, I got a fairly expensive automobile.
Yes, you do.
I have a Porsche 928, and you know, man, when it's wet out, these things don't go.
Yeah, well.
I don't think the cost of a car has to do with its go-ability.
Not in the rain. This thing will hydroplane
your tail off, man.
It's so aerodynamically designed that when it gets up to high speed, that it just sort of... It floats above the roadway there.
It wants to fly. That's what it does.
Yeah, unfortunately, I don't want to fly with it. I'm going to kill myself going home Friday. Good morning, Z100.
Yes, I just called to let you guys know that article you said you read about Elvis.
That is true, isn't it?
Yes, it is. I read it about a month or so ago.
Yep.
In one of those newspaper rags.
Did you hear these doubting Thomases around me this morning that did not believe that was true?
I heard it just as I woke up, yes.
A Dutch anthropologist, his name is Horn, H-O-O-R-N, Deventer, D-E-V-E-N-T-E-R. It's an actual tribe in the South China Seas that worship Elvis Presley as a god because a big old crate of Elvis Presley memorabilia washed ashore from a wrecked ship.
Yeah, boy.
That's right.
They said, oh, my God, or something else.
Hey, I got to tell you guys are fantastic.
Well, thank you so much, and you ain't nothing but a hound dog.
Thanks a lot.
See you later. Good morning. 7:49 in the morning, 7:49 and feeling fine. Is it time for Shadow?
Yes, it is, and here is Nancy Remy.
Hello.
We've got soggy roadway conditions out from Westchester, but it looks like all major roadways are open, including the Sawmill River Parkway, with some puddles to watch out for, though, in through to Ashford Avenue. Quite a busy one as you're making your way in from New Jersey, and that's over on eastbound 80 with a jam up out in from the Rockaway vicinity that continues right through to Parsippany and Patterson on Route 80. 46 and 23 are all tangled up at their merge in Wayne because because of the flooding conditions. And we've now got 20 to 25 minute delays at the Holland to the Lincoln Tunnel inbound, 10 minutes at the George Washington Bridge and building quickly. And watch for delays building up on the eastern spur of the New Jersey Turnpike both ways between 15 and 16E. Here's the deal over on the westbound LIE, generally slow for 4 miles leading in toward exit 51 at Deer Park Avenue. Top speed at about 15 miles an hour. A tangle up over on the westbound Southern State out from Suffolk right in through to Nassau County. Very heavy past exit 20. And on the Sandy Coast, northbound right lane closed approaching the LIE with a 5-car accident being cleared. It's already a mile and a half delay. Back in 20 minutes in the RE system, that's the Z100 Shadow Traffic and Transit Report.
10 before 8 o'clock in the morning here in the Morning Zoo. Ross, you haven't met Arnie Greenberg yet, have you?
No, I haven't. I haven't had the pleasure, Scott.
Yeah, he's a great guy. He's one of the guys who runs that Snapple juice and soda outfit. And I was talking to him the other day. You know what he told me?
What?
He says that when Jim Baker gets together with friends for fun, that's what he does. He drinks Snapple juice at the party.
Is that what he does?
At least that's what Arnie was telling me.
Yeah, right.
Why is that? Because Jim Baker's a pure man. Snapple juice is 100% pure fruit juice.
Yeah, all right.
Not imitation. Not imitation. Forget it. This is the real thing.
Pure.
For all you first-time Snapple users.
It's pure.
No chemicals, no sugar, no additives, no artificial anything. Just the real thing. It's pure. Great.
And you mean to tell me Jim Baker drinks that?
Snapple juice. Every time he has a big party, he has friends over to the hotel or motel.
No alcohol. He just drinks Snapple.
There you go. And you can do the same thing. Pathmark, Charles & Company, selected Krauser stores, Red Apple Food Town, ShopRite, everywhere. You can look for Snapple juice or soda. Be like the people in the news.
The Bakers.
Drink Snapple.
I guess Jessica Hunt wouldn't drink it.
She doesn't touch the big thing.
Drug abuse has become a serious New York crisis. Listen to what baseball manager Lou Piniella has to say on the subject.
When you manage my particular ball club, you really get to know the true meaning of the word pressure. Sometimes I fight back or laugh it off. Sometimes I even ignore it. There are plenty of ways to handle it, but I'd never, ever turn the drugs. That's no way to deal with things. No way at all. Unless you're into destroying yourself. And if you're that dumb, you'll never be a member of my club.
Buck Williams of the New Jersey Nets shares Lou's feelings.
I spent my whole life pushing, shoving, fighting for every inch. Basketball's one tough game. The last thing I need is to start using cocaine. I've already seen what it can do to other guys, on the court and off. And it's not a pretty sight. You want to wreck your life with cocaine? Then I got news for you, buddy. You're a loser. A real loser. And no losers ever gonna be a member of this man's club.
The preceding message is paid for by members only, makers of apparel and other fine products.
The Z-Cream from the net. Are you at the Z-100?
All right.
This is the morning show with hair on it.
7:53, a wet, rainy, dangerous Monday, April the 6th, 1987. Gather around the radio. Your zoo is on the air everywhere.
I'm not afraid of the dark.
Classic C100, having a good time on the radio. Don't let that rain spoil your day, right, Ross?
Yeah, we have rain right through tomorrow. Higher on 52 today, but don't let it get you down. 43 degrees right now in the Monday morning zoo.
All right, let's go to the studio lines right now. We like to give away stuffers. I mean, we're giving away some nice prizes this morning. We'll send you to see the Z100 screening of Walt Disney's classic, The Aristocats, at the Ziegfeld Theater. That'll be Saturday the 11th. We'll sit you right behind Leslie Murther, so you really have a lot of fun, all right? Five winners now, eh? But you don't have to sit behind Leslie Murther if you don't want.
Studio lines are open, 955-9090 in New York.
From Z100, home of the world's coolest operations manager, 7:58 in the morning here at Z100 Radio.
Wait a minute. What are you talking about Steve Kingston again for?
Just got a call from Granny, you know, our favorite, one of our grandma DJ listeners.
Oh, yeah.
Right. Said she saw me. I guess it did run last night, John.
Yeah, it did. It was on several times yesterday.
The new Z100 birthday contest, round 3 TV commercial featuring the chimpanzee. This is a great chip. Me and him became great friends. In fact, I'm going over to his house for dinner this week.
You're kidding.
Yeah, this is great. He lives on the island.
Zippy's the guy on the David Letterman show.
And he's in our commercials with us, so I'm going to go over. He's going to have. Have you ever seen that guy Zippy on the David Letterman show, Nancy?
Not yet, no. I can't wait to see the commercials.
This guy's great, man. Me and him are close friends.
Yeah, Nancy.
Running partners.
Nancy, if there's any confusion, the guy with all the hair is Zippy.
Thanks, Ross.
Thank you, Ross. Z100 Shadow Traffic is on. Morning, Nancy.
Good morning. And Ross, from one optimist to another, it's going to be a rotten day. Traffic-wise, we've already got a 3-mile backup south end New York State Thruway toward the eastbound Tappan Zee Bridge, 25 minutes inbound of the Holland and the Lincoln Tunnel, and 20 at most approaches now at the George Washington Bridge, but 35-minute delays inbound from the Route 4 approach. Route 80 is a jam up eastbound for at least 2 miles out from Rockaway. It stays heavy right through to Parsippany and Patterson this morning. And, of course, flooding conditions over in Wayne are making it difficult out on 46 and 23, although 23 is open in the area. South Bend Eastern Spur of the New Jersey Turnpike tangled up at 15W. We have the center lane construction and a one-car accident blocking the left lane. Our patrol unit Metro 1 is southbound on the BQE, creeping along from Northern Boulevard and Queens Boulevard at 10 miles an hour. Slow again in toward the Williamsburg with right lane flooding. And making your way westbound LIE, generally heavy for 4 miles in toward Deer Park Avenue. It stays heavy right in toward exit 39. Northern State is a slow go in toward the Sunken Meadow and Route 110 with right lane flooding. And northbound on the Sad Dakotas at the LIE. As transit's okay, an alternate side of the street parking regulations in effect. Back in 20 minutes in the RE system, that's the Z100 Shadow Traffic and Transit Report.
Good morning, everyone. everyone. It's 43 degrees at 8 o'clock. I'm Claire Stevens with the Z100 Information Update brought to you by Sunoco. As Nancy just indicated, conditions in northern New Jersey aren't too good. The rivers are still cresting. Hundreds of Wayne residents had to get out of their homes as the Passaic River Basin had its worst flooding in 3 years. They might get back into their homes sometimes this evening. Governor Kane has declared a limited state of emergency in the area. Rescuers have recovered one body and one car from the swollen Schoharie Creek in Amsterdam, New York, where a thruway bridge collapsed yesterday. Although rescue operations resumed at daybreak, authorities don't expect to find any more victims from among the people in the three cars and one tractor trailer that plunged 80 feet. There's a very, very wild current there, and they don't expect to find anybody. Family members and friends filed into a Massapequa funeral home yesterday to pay their last respects to Peter and John Phillips, brothers who had been killed in a car crash just minutes after Peter was married on Friday. The bride has had one leg amputated below the knee. She and her sister, who'd been her maid of honor, are in critical condition. They don't know of the deaths of the Phillips brothers yet. Police think the tragedy may have resulted because a car was involved in a drag race. Gary Stern's supposed to bring his niece, Rachel Rouser, home to New Jersey from Florida today. He's been given temporary custody of the little girl after her father was arrested for trying to sell her to Stern. However, a judge has just awarded custody to the girl's stepmother and is expected Stern will resist surrendering the girl. The Post reports that crippled police officer Stephen McDonald will be leaving Bellevue in about 2 weeks to begin rehabilitation treatment out in Colorado. Jessica Hahn now says Jim Baker got her woozy on wine and then forced her to have sex with him that night in the Florida motel, and that the minister could not get enough, in her words. And after that, Hahn says she was forced to have sex with yet another evangelist. A drum set sat idle in front of a casket at an L.A. cemetery yesterday in a funeral service for Buddy Rich. Among the mourners was Mel Torme, who said that the drummer had rap-a-tat-tat his way into millions of hearts. He had died last week of cancer. Z100 Sports, all three of our local hockey teams saw action last night. My Rangers were just destroyed by the Canadiens, 8-3. Isles did in the Flyers, 9-5. And the Devils were outskating by the Caps, 6-5 in OT. Down in Washington, D.C., the Mets had the Phillies 1-0, but the game was called after 5. This afternoon at the Garden, Knicks honor Julius Erving, and they play Philadelphia. Out in Detroit, 1-35. The Yanks open their season by sending Dennis Rasmussen to the hill against Jack Morris. That is, if the weather cooperates. And there's going to be an announcement later on this morning as to whether the umpires are going to be striking or not. Coming up tonight, the Hagler-Leonard fight out in Las Vegas. Our Z100 weather is going to be wet for the next few days. Periods of rain right through tomorrow. Daytime highs around 52. It's going down to near 40 degrees overnight. Partly cloudy skies come Wednesday, if we can wait that long. Currently, it's 44 in the Meadowlands, 42 at Roosevelt Field, 43 at the Empire State Building at 8:03. I'm Claire Stevens for Z100.
Edgar, let's go someplace special tonight.
Herb's Bullerama.
No.
Sid's Pool Hall.
No, Murray's. Honey. Let's go out of town on Eastern's Moonlight Special.
Why is it special?
Because of incredible fares to 11 cities across the country every night. $69 to Chicago, $99 to Dallas, $129 to San Francisco. And I can take you along for only $25 extra.
Don't we need advance reservations?
Not on the Moonlight Special. The flights are late at night when romantic people like us like to travel.
Romantic? Oh, my little cheese Danish.
Speaking of food, there's a small charge for snacks and beverages.
Oh, I gotta go pack.
Don't pack too much. There's no baggage check-in, so just carry on one garment bag and one bag that fits under your seat.
As long as we can carry on.
Take someone special on Eastern's Moonlight Special for only $25 extra from April 1st till May 19th. Fares are one-way in coach. Blackout dates apply. For details and other restrictions, call your travel agent or Eastern.
What a romantic flight.
Edgar, you really do look better in the moonlight.
Thanks.
WHTZ, Newark, New York City.
When you put up your own money for a service station, you have a whole different attitude.
Meet a member of Sunoco's Ultra Pros from Sunoco Ultra Service Center, where you get service like it used to be.
These days, service can be a joke. So if I'm going to be successful, I've got to give you the kind of personal service you're not used to. Like, I know my work is so good that I'll give you a 6-month or 6,000-mile warranty, whichever comes first. Hey, that's 3 months and 2,000 miles better than most service stations. And besides written estimates and warranties, I promise to be here if you need me. Yeah, I guarantee me. And after all, it's my business. In fact, it's my life. And I still know how to say thank you. Thank you.
Sunoco's Ultra Pros. For service like it used to be. Only at Sunoco Ultra Service Centers.
Come into a participating Ultra Service Center dealer by May 16th and get a lube, oil, and filter plus 10-point safety check for only $16.95. See dealer for details.
Excuse me.
Yes?
I think I have magnesia.
What?
I don't know who I am or where I am, but I think I'm having a pretty good time.
Well, sir, this is an R&S Strauss Discount Auto Store, and we're having a big grand opening celebration.
We are?
Mm-hmm.
Did I get a party hat?
No party hats, but every R&S Strauss store is celebrating with terrific grand opening savings on everything you need for your car.
I don't remember if I even have a car.
Well, remember R&S Strauss. We have over 75 stores, so we buy right and pass the savings on to you.
But who am I? And are those guys in the red vests coming to get me?
No, no. They're R&S Strauss friendly service people. They're here to answer your questions, so be careful, sir. You're going to bump your head on that.
Ow!
You okay?
Now I remember.
Yes?
I'm at the R&S Strauss grand opening.
Yes, but who are you?
That I forgot.
That he forgot.
All R&S Strauss stores are celebrating the grand opening of their new store in Yonkers at McLean and Romaine with savings on Purolator filters. After $1 rebate from Purolator, oil filters are 99 cents each, and air filters are just $1.99 through Saturday at R&S Strauss.
I'm not afraid to Britain is back at the zoo. Britain is back at the zoo. Britain is back at the zoo.
Britain is back at the zoo. Britain is back at the zoo. He went away to Philippi, but now Ross is back at the zoo. Murphy was here for a year, and then they went and hired Ross again. Because of the wonderful things he does. So welcome back, Ross Britton. Back to the morning zoo.
It is 8:12. This is Captain Cool with President Anna coming for, sir. Woo, this hour, we have a $100 gift certificate giveaway to J&R Music World and Mr. Realty. And what a rotten day outside. Periods of rain right through tomorrow. It's 43 and rainy right now in the zoo.
Times that we spent hiding out from the rain under the corner tent. I laughed and she'd smile. It would last for a while. You don't know what you got till you lose it all again. Listen to the listen to the bluegrass band and takes the chill from the air until they play the last song. I'll do my time for keeping you off my mind, but there's moments that I find I'm not feeling so strong. Listen to the running down
little tune called Mandolin Rain from Z100. Bruce Hornsby in the range. Played it for our friends over there at the Riviera Sandwich Shop in Jamaica, Queens. And we got the Z100 Morning Zoo cranked up. 8:16 in the morning, 16 after 8 o'clock. Good morning, Claire.
Good morning, Scott.
Welcome back to John Bell from vacation.
Good morning, everybody. Good to be back.
Tell us about your trip. Now, where'd you go?
I went down to the south of Spain, and I had a ball. It was incredible. It was really great. Only problem I had was driving those mountainous roads in Spain. I'm a little bit of a chicken when it comes to one way in each direction and nothing on the side but a cliff that goes 5,000 feet down.
Wait a minute. You said the only problem you had was the mountains and the road there?
Yeah, driving along those mountainous roads. I was scared to death.
Did you get stuck in that, the strike?
Yeah, I got caught in that. That wasn't really so bad.
Oh, Lord, I must have been just dreaming this morning. I thought you were talking about some other mountains when you came in this morning.
Oh, he was talking about the beaches.
Thanks, Ross. Yeah, well, they have topless bathing in south of Spain, as you know, Scott, from being in France. They had the same thing there.
I was not as enthralled by it as you seem to be.
Well, I have to admit that this was my first experience with topless bathing, and there were some outstanding examples of,
of
topless bathing there.
Gotcha. A lot of pulchritude, huh?
Mm-hmm.
That's enough. It was 8:17 in the morning, Z100. Good morning.
Right after breakfast, too.
Good morning.
You loved it.
Scott.
Is this you I'm talking to?
No, Scott, I want to talk to Claire.
Claire's right here.
Right here.
Claire, first of all, the umpire strike was settled.
Okay.
It was on your 7th. And the other thing is, Claire, say a prayer that we can at least take Philly again.
Oh, we will do it.
Please.
We'll do it.
We'll do it.
Relax. We'll do it.
Thank you, Claire.
We'll do it.
Bye-bye.
Hang in there. It's our year.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
God.
What do they call those new machines that just repeat all the time? JR's got one back there?
I don't know. It's like a digitizer or something like that.
Yeah.
Call me what you want. We'll take the cup this year.
You know, one that goes.
What cup?
No, nobody.
Nobody.
No, 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 nobody gives away more. You know, like next year is our year.
Right.
Got that right.
Anyway,
this year is our year.
This year is our year. Okay.
Right.
I get confused whether it was last year, 20 years ago, or
maybe 40 years ago.
I saw a disturbing stat yesterday. You see all the baseball players every year and the managers and George Steinbrenner always whine about the umpiring.
Mm-hmm.
And oh, how Bush League it is.
That's right.
And then you see a stat like I saw yesterday. The Pittsburgh Pirates pay like $8.5 million to players that don't even play for them any longer.
That's right.
Oh boy.
You know, like the Mets did George Foster last year.
Sure. Old contract obligations.
$8.5 million, and that's twice as much as the umpires are paid.
All together.
Boy.
You get it?
Jeez.
And then they want, and the owners complain. The Pirates are paying twice as much money to players not to play for them. And the umpires make.
And I get the feeling that the Pirates are not atypical here.
Yes, yeah, sure. You're right.
You're right.
Mm-hmm. Why do you think Lee Mazzelli was so happy to get out of there?
Also tonight, Sugar Ray Leonard, Marvis Marvelin Hagler fight. You've heard of the Thriller in Manila. This is, I guess you call it the Las Vegas eye test, huh, Bill?
Oh, come on, Ross.
Thank you so much. Daylight savings time began yesterday morning. Did you set all your clocks back? I set all your clocks ahead an hour, rather.
Right.
Leap and spring forward and jump back, Jack. One of those.
What?
So funny, because when you're a morning disc jockey, everyone thinks when it's your birthday or Christmas or any type of gift is given to you, they always give you a clock.
Or a radio.
Or a radio.
Yep.
Now, we've got two automobiles in my family, and that's that 4x4 vehicle.
Right. Mm-hmm.
Which all have clocks in them. I got about four watches. Well, only one's expensive. The rest of, you know, like Nets watches and
right.
Cheap, you know, Mickey Mouse watch.
Souvenir type stuff.
And then I counted yesterday in my home, there's a total of 14 clocks.
How long did it take you to reset them all?
I started this. I was going to walk around and say, I'll be doing this all at once.
Right.
And I kept forgetting, where's another one? Oh, there's one in the kitchen, and there's a digital one here, and there's one in the shower, and I was running around, and each one you had to set differently.
Right. One on the coffee maker.
Yeah, that's great. Right. Yeah, I remember.
One on the VCR.
Right.
Yep. You got to get that one, too.
And all of them are about 2 or 3 minutes different.
Yes.
20 after 8 o'clock in the morning, ladies and gentlemen, it's time for that Monday rainy morning mystery only. This hour it's good for.
It's the $100 gift certificate of the Wiz. Good for everything in the world of audio, video, records, and tape. Nobody beats the Wiz.
I thought this would be a good one for a day like today. Listen carefully, give us title and artist. If you have anything in 30 days or less, over $50, you can call in now. There you have it. Studio lines are open. 21 after 8.
Endless Sequel Motion Picture Productions proudly presents the ultimate Rocky Five. Sylvester Stallone starring as Rocky Balboa. Rocky must fight for his life against the most awesome force to ever appear on the silver screen.
Oh my gosh.
Yes, Rocky finally meets face to face with Popeye the Sailor Man.
Whoa, blow me down.
Hey, yo, Nick. Hey, this guy looks just like you.
Whoa.
What do you think you are, smart guy?
Hey, Sailor Boy. Like, drop the vegetables and let's fight.
Whoa, that's all I can stand. I can't stand no more.
Rocky V, starring Sylvester Stallone and Popeye the Sailor Man. Coming soon to a low theater near you.
Hey, yo, Adrian! Adrian!
Yo, olive oil! Yo, olive oil!
In the beginning, Valerie was on Monday night. And it was good.
Honey, I'm home.
Daddy, Daddy!
Wonderful, darling. You're just in time for Valerie.
Yes, I know. Life is good.
But then there came a time of wandering, and a great confusion was upon the land.
I thought it was on tonight.
No, that was last week.
Where is Valerie? I don't know. I just...
What's wrong with Dad? Can't let the children see us like this.
But it came to pass that on Monday nights, a strange light was seen in the sky. And behold, it was the craft of an alien being, and he was called Elf.
That's my name. Don't wear it out.
And so it was written that unto Monday nights a great hour of comedy would be bestowed, with Elf at 8 and Valerie at 8:30, as it was in the beginning. And it was good.
Isn't it wonderful?
Yes, Monday nights are special again.
Elf and Valerie, Monday nights on NBC. A match made in heaven.
Get fresh with us at Pathmark number one. Getting fresh is our number one goal. And we reach it in fresh meat, fresh fish, fresh fruit, fresh vegetables, fresh dairy and deli. So get fresh with Pathmark.
Fresh, get fresh, get fresh with us at Pathmark.
Come to Pathmark for fresh savings all through the store. Save on freshly sliced Swift Butterball Deli Turkey Breast, just $1.99 a half pound. And fresh USDA Choice Beef Shoulder for London Broil, only $1.69 a pound. At Pathmark, where you're the one who's number one, 24 hours a day, 7 days a week.
Fresh, get fresh, get fresh with us at Pathmark.
We're number one because you get fresh with us.
Waiting for me, baby.
Now,
Aretha Franklin, George Michael, the one and only No Baloney Morning Zoo, Ross Pertain, the Vanilla Gorilla is back. Jack Murphy is starting off his job out there in San Diego on that brand new Q106 radio station. Good luck to him, and talk to him over the weekend. He's having a lot of fun. And today, baseball kicks off. How about the weather up in Detroit there, Mr. Bell?
It's going to be great, Scott. A little morning cloudiness, but then it's going to be about 51 and sunny this afternoon by game time.
All right. Dennis Rasmussen on the mound for the Yankees. And Jack Morris, who was 21-8 last year, kicks off at 1:35 today. Tomorrow, the Mets get it underway. Baseball time again. And, you know, it, I remember last year when I was here, Dean Thacker gets real mad on opening day because a lot of the sales weasels
disappear.
Like, yeah, well, Jeff Dennett sits back in his office and he turns on another radio station. Guess which one? Your old station, Ross.
That's right.
77 WAVE. And he always turns it on back there, and Dean walks by and says, "What the hell is he doing listening to that station?" I said, "Dean, the ball game's on."
Bingo!
Leave him alone. Good morning, Z100. Kim Richardson, please.
Here I am.
From Brooklyn?
Yes.
Where do you work, Kim?
9X.
All right, you got that 8 o'clock raining down, pouring, nasty-looking mystery oldie for us?
Yes. Hot fun in the summertime by Sly and the Family Stone.
All right. All right. Oh. Hot fun in the summertime, Sly and the Family Stone. I thought that we just kind of put this on, cheer people up a little bit. Congratulations, you got that $100 gift certificate from the Wiz, Kim. Thanks for calling.
Okay, thank you.
Music, WHTZ 100 opening day, 1987 professional baseball season. The Yankees play the Tigers in Detroit. Mets open their season tomorrow afternoon. We'll have a special contest for you people going to the game. Sugar Ray Leonard, Marvelous Marvin Hagler fight tonight. The hell time's that thing going to be over anyway?
It'll be about 1 o'clock in the morning, Scott.
All right, let's see. Governor Tom Kaine from New Jersey be visiting the Hackettstown Middle School today at 11 o'clock in the morning.
Hi, Tommy.
Good to see you. Good to hear from you. Let's see, the 22nd annual Welcome Home Dinner in honor of the New York Mets at the Georgia Ballroom, Sheraton Center tonight. Let's see, the host, the Knicks host the 76ers in honor of Dr. J this afternoon. And tomorrow night, the Bon Jovi concert. Other big news, he dropped me a letter. Want me to mention this on the air?
Who's that?
Who did?
Dear Scott, I know we kid around, but please mention my appearance on the Hollywood Squares this week.
Oh, no.
So I'll give you a hint. It's on ABC stationery.
Regis Philbin. Dork alert, dork alert, dork alert. Yeah, Regis is going to be on Hollywood Squares.
Kidding.
It's a shame they couldn't have planned that April Fool's trick.
Punched out Regis.
You know the one where the lady catches the guy cheating? See, hopefully he could be up in that top square up there. Way up there on top.
Oh!
Oh! Oh, my God.
But my luck, he'd land on his head, and that wouldn't hurt anything. All right, 8:33 in the morning, we got those Razzie calls, those Razzie dolls. You seen those things?
Yeah,
oh, they're
great.
Horrible.
From Matchbox Toys, tickets to see Jack Wagner, and Claire has the official office of the day.
And it's Brer Eye Associates there in Patterson, New Jersey. We're saluting Anna, Ann, Dot, Eva, Eunice, Barbara, Marianne. They're all going to get the Dunkin' Donuts to have with their coffee, the Z-shirts, the Mr. Leonard buttons, and those calendar boosters.
So we have brought into the office independent radio so we can listen to the Z. Our music is piped in. They do not allow anything other than elevator music. We've been lifting for a couple of years now. We want Z shirts and Z hats, and we love Mr. Leonard. Please, please. Sound like a James Brown. Please, 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 please. It's in Patterson. G.K. Brer, M.D., F.A.C.S. What's that?
F.A.C.S. It's
probably an eye doctor type thing.
No, I think that has to do with plastic surgery.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow.
As they bounce around the office there. And B.S. Brer. Yeah, they always give freebies to the people that work in those places. 8:34 in the morning. Don't forget the... You don't believe me?
Please, Scott. God. Just move right. on. Just
check, just check on it. Just check on it.
Keep going.
You're talking to a guy who knows such things. As you know, the Z100 television commercial premiered this weekend.
Sure did. Mm-hmm. I saw it about 5 times.
I mean, that's the one way. This is the brand new birthday contest, which kicks off Thursday at 7:20. The reason we run these TV commercials is that a lot of people, believe it or not, I know that sometimes, especially Gary Fisher finds it hard to believe, listen to other radio stations occasionally.
No!
Oh, you're kidding.
And to get to them, we put TV commercials on. Not very many, but we put a few on. We got there's ladies on the line that she just called in a minute ago to check and make sure she had the right station and the right phone number.
Good morning.
Hi.
Is this the number of Z100?
Yes, ma'am. This is the number of Z100.
Okay, because this is the one that we're going to get ready for our birthdays on Thursday.
How did you find out about that?
I've seen it on TV.
Boy, I'm sorry about that guy they got on there doing the commercials. We couldn't get anybody else to do them. That's a sorry-looking character.
Oh, he is not nice.
Oh, he's not?
No, he's a nice-looking fellow.
Well, he's kind of cute, isn't he?
Compared to the monkey.
All right, well, thanks for listening. That's going to be Thursday morning at 7:20.
Okay, I just wanted to check the number because, boy, the day that it announced my grandson's birthday, we couldn't find the number.
It's 100.3, and you're on the right number.
Okay, doll. Thank you.
There you have it. Somebody else watched the George Michael Sports Machine last night. Good morning.
Good morning, Scott.
Hello.
I just wanted to let you know that FACS means Faculty American College of Surgeons.
Mm, okay.
What does that indicate?
He's a cutter then, huh?
Apparently.
Mm-hmm. I try to stay away from as many of those guys as possible, to tell you the truth.
Z100, 24 minutes before 9. Let's check in with Shadow Traffic and Nancy Freemy.
Nancy what?
Nancy Freemy.
Freemy.
Eastbound Staten Island Expressway, slow moving now for over a mile toward Bradley Avenue. Rubbernecking delays, lots of police and emergency activity. An accident involving an overturned car off to the right shoulder. And then another 2 miles of heavy traffic just in toward the Verrazano Bridge. Westbound Belt Parkway, slow for 2 miles at 15 miles an hour maximum coming in through to the Shell Road construction zone. And over at the inbound Gowanus and BQE combination, still heavy right up in toward the Brooklyn Bridge. The southbound BQE creeps along at 10 miles an hour from Queens Boulevard right down in toward the Williamsburg. Right lane flooding and potholes are the problem this morning. LIE traffic out from Nassau County at 15 to 20 miles an hour from Shelter Rock Road right in through to the fairgrounds. And we're very heavy on the eastbound side as well. It's still a tangle up out from Suffolk County on the westbound LIE. Same goes for the northbound Sandy Coast leading in toward the Long Island Expressway due to an earlier multi-vehicle accident. And checking over on the southbound New York State Thruway, give yourself about 2.5 miles of backed up traffic toward the eastbound Tappan Z Bridge. 25 minutes all the way around at our Hudson River crossings in from New Jersey and the Garden State Parkway northbound bumper to bumper from the Union up and toward the Essex Toll. Back in 20 minutes in the RE system, that's the Z100 Shadow Traffic and Transit Report.
Burger, soda, and fries. So when are we going to go out beautiful?
When you get some new wheels. Huh? You were going to sell this antique and pick up something with a little class, remember?
I'm trying. I'm advertising. Good deal, too. Huh? Don't pay until I sell it.
Yeah, how many calls you get?
Well, you want the hard number or approximately?
Either one.
Approximately None.
Mm, could be, Hotshot. You're advertising in the wrong paper.
If it takes forever to move your car, then it's time for Auto Action Classified in the Daily News. Your Auto Action Classified puts you in the driver's seat with New York's biggest newspaper audience. Easy on your budget, too. For as little as $18, you can run your Auto Action Classified in the Daily News for 2 weekends on Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. That's 6 days of advertising in all. Charge it on Visa or MasterCard. Call area code 212-949-AUTO. That's 949-AUTO. And catch on to New York's fastest growing classified section. That sounds like the right paper.
Take a number, make a memo, take it all to do it out. It's a city full of chances and you can check it out. Every face a story, every block a world. A boy on every corner with his eye on every girl.
There are over 100,000 New York telephone public phones in our city. And the people who put them there work 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, to make sure that the service you get is nothing but the best. Because that's just what the people who live here deserve.
The nightlife is the right life. The day shines in the park. The city of the emeralds got an apple for a heart. No matter where you travel,
Telephone, a NYNEX company.
Z Morning Zoo.
Ma'am, what do you want to hear?
Keep me hanging on.
Do it a little bit more. I think I'm getting it. What was it again?
Keep me hanging on.
Is that all you know?
Well, set me free. What don't you think?
Thank you.
name is Kim Wilde. That's called You Keep Me Hanging On, 843. Don't forget, the Z100 gives you the world's, well, sickest, craziest, you decide this afternoon. I guess you've noticed my inability to describe this character. You can check it out for yourself this afternoon. I guess Magic Matt Allen is his name, and he'll be here this afternoon, right? It's 3 o'clock, we hope, anyway. All right, 8:44 in the morning here at Z100. If you'd like to go see the Michael J. Fox motion picture, The Secret of My Success, studio lines are open right now, free from Z100.
Scott and Ross, The Morning Zoo. Z100.
If you want to request a comedy routine or a song, we'll open the header lines right now, 800-527-9090 on a wet Monday.
Never finding the answers. Crazy.
takes us into deep from New York's number one, Z100, 849 in the morning. Don't forget to all you people who participated in that big little Kathleen Shannon TV debut, Romper Room with Miss Molly. We'll be taping this coming Thursday. It'll be shown a week from Friday. I think it's Good Friday, if I'm not mistaken. It'll be shown on television. But the taping is this Thursday, my little baby DJ's TV debut.
Wow.
Should be kind of interesting. And later tonight on the Jack the Wax Show, we'll announce the winner of the Bon Jovi Cinderella concert backstage blowout. I think there's another pair of tickets slipping around the station somewhere, too. In a Bon Jovi blowout weekend. Pick a ticket, anything you want. 849. Studio lines are open. It's kind of a, I don't know, it's one of those melancholy days today.
Yeah, gray and rainy.
When it's a stay in bed type day.
It's a day like today. You just kind of open the phone lines and chat with the folks this morning if you got a special bit you want to hear. And several of the calls this morning have been about another thing that kind of brings me down. And I think an awful lot of people are a little depressed about that horrible, horrible accident, the wedding accident on the island.
Yes, that was terrible.
Awful.
It was really terrible.
Yeah. Pete Phillips, the groom, and John Phillips, his brother and best man, lost their lives, and Carol Ann Zagorski's fighting for hers. I think she's now Carol Ann Zagorski Phillips without a husband. Mm-hmm. And they took a leg off for her. And it happened as they were on the way to the reception, Lido Beach. And it was such a shocking, horrible accident. And all I can say is our prayers and our thoughts are with the families this morning. Just, I think most everyone was touched with it. And that was on television, on the radio, and the newspapers. Yeah. Just a sad, I really can't put too much into words. It's just the way you feel inside. 10 before 9 o'clock here at Z100 Radio, the Monday Morning Zoo. We mentioned the office today. Mr. Leonard has not yet called in.
Oh, what happened to him today?
I don't know where the heck
he
is.
He even showed up last week.
Yeah, he was here while you were gone.
Wow.
Reporting for duty.
Mm-hmm.
We mentioned Regis Philbin, going to be on the Hollywood Squares show. Celebrity birthdays today. Let's see here. Mary Lou Henner, 33. Bob Marley, the late leader of the group, the Wailers. Mm-hmm. Lowell Thomas, radio newscaster. Used to work with Claire when she first got into radio. Billy D. Williams.
Oh, sure, Claire.
You're right.
Born in the city. Michelle Phillips from the Mamas and Papas. And the late Harry Houdini, who was a good friend, believe it or not, our new afternoon disc jockey.
The magician?
Yeah.
You.
Both of them. Kind of an amusing column. Flip Bondi, who's a basketball writer for the, isn't he with the news, isn't he?
Yeah,
he's
the
news.
The Daily News. I clipped his column out from yesterday's paper because I found it kind of amusing. You know, Scotty Sterling, who's not known as one of the better management people in the game of professional basketball. In fact, he's one of the worst available, but you know how they are over there at Gulf and Western.
Mm-hmm.
Next.
Oh, God.
We're making friends fast today.
Oh, yeah.
Well, don't worry. We're among the majority in this deal. Going into last night's game at the Garden, Scotty Sterling, who is the GM, had not been president at Knick game, hadn't even showed up for 2 months.
Whoa.
Club official says he was out. They say he was out scouting college games. There's no college games going on right now.
Been over for a month.
So Flip Bondi's figured out what really has. He's got three choices for you to take.
Because
this guy Sterling, they won't open the... He's really mean to the writers, the guys who work and bust their buns day to day trying to report the news and all that. He's got three theories on this Scotty Sterling where he is. One theory is that he was fired on February the 15th, but they were afraid to announce it.
Okay. All right.
No one will write about it.
Oh.
His second theory, Scotty Sterling is really Casper Weinberger.
Now that one makes sense.
Deals are sketchy on this one, but a source insisted Weinberger was hustled out of his office one day by three armed men. A lookalike was planted in Weinberger's place. But here's the one I like. I think this number three theory on what happened to Scotty Sterling to the Knicks is the real McCoy. Says Sterling is really Duncan the mascot. He's hiding. He's working as Duncan the mascot, the Nets mascot.
That's cold.
And come to think of it, looks a little like him, too. Z100 shadow traffic is on. Claire, what's the problem out there?
Well, southbound New York's day thruway heavy for nearly 3 miles into the Tappan Zee because the far right lane is closed for repairs. Southbound BQE very heavy from Queens Boulevard to the Williamsburg Bridge because of right lane flooding and a lot of potholes. Northbound FDR very slow under Gracie Mansion because of a large pothole in the left lane there. Southbound West Side Highway very heavy from the GWs down through the 90s. Westbound Northern State, bumper to bumper from Veterans Highway to Route 110 because of right lane flooding, and then travel slow again from Shelter Rock Road to the City Line. Eastbound Staten Island Expressway, slow for a mile into Bradley Avenue. There is an overturned car on the right shoulder, and then traffic's very heavy for 2 miles to the Verrazano Bridge. There is a lot of assorted flooding in Wayne, New Jersey. Too many areas to mention specifically, but you're going to find problems there. If you're crossing the Hudson, inbound Holland and Lincoln, 20 to 25-minute delays. Inbound GW, about a 30-minute backup from routes 80, 95, and the Palisades, 20 from Route 46. Outbound tunnels have about a 10-minute wait, and that's Z100 shadow traffic.
Thank you, Claire Barry. 854, we're taking calls this morning. What you want to hear, it's kind of one of those days where you just want to call on the radio. If you got a song you want to hear, an oldie, maybe we'll dig out some oldies from 9 to 10. This morning, or you got a one of those zoo bits you want to hear, one of those zoo commercials. Let's go to the phones. Good morning, radio station Z100. Congratulations. You have touched bases with the Nut Hut.
Hey, how you doing?
Oh, fine, fine, super fine.
Good. Listen, I got a request, man.
All right.
I'm getting ready to go to Florida this morning, but before I go, I really want to hear the James Brown burglar alarm.
You're getting ready to go to Florida?
Yes.
How are you traveling?
By plane.
You don't have to have a spare seat there next to you.
Hey, I can check.
Man, I'd love to be hopping on there with you.
Okay.
Where are you going in Florida?
Jacksonville.
Oh, never mind.
It's late at night. You're fast asleep, and a shadowy figure is about to break into your home. But you're protected. Ow! 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 Yes, it's the James Brown Home Security Alarm. Ow! Ow! The hardest working alarm in the safety business. Designed by the godfather of home protection himself. Ow, ow, ow. The James Brown alarm protects you from burglars, vandals, peeping toms. And if you act now, we'll include at no extra cost the patented James Brown Hot Pants Fire Alarm. Ow, ow, ow. So put the soul patrol on your keyhole. With the James Brown Home Security System. You'll say,
I feel good.
When you shop at your neighborhood CarQuest Auto Parts store, your parts are guaranteed to perform. It's a guarantee that's backed up by over 2,300 CarQuest stores. It's CarQuest Coast to Coast Guarantee, and only CarQuest has it.
The right parts, the right price, the right advice. CarQuest gets it right. It feels good when you finish.
Our coast-to-coast guarantee covers top-quality items like gates, belts, and hoses. If your car's belts and hoses are 4 years old or older, it's time to change them. So stop by today during our big super coupon sale at CarQuest.
It feels good when you finish what you start. We make it easy to work on your car. The right parts.
Citibank branches are open late, so you can open your 86 IRA. But if you go to some other banks, you may find it's too late.
Sorry, we're closed. A comeback between 9 and 3. This is a bank, you know.
At Citibank, we're not keeping bankers' hours. We've got branches open late all over town to help you beat the April 15th IRA deadline. And we've got more choices of IRAs for you, too, including choices that may surprise you. 4 different investment portfolios, mutual funds, brokerage investments, and all the choices you would expect, insured money market accounts, savings, CDs. Sooner or later, you'll wish you'd opened your IRA at Citibank. We're staying open late, so you can open one now. Better hurry in. Check our newspaper ads for Citibank's late IRA hours or call 1-800-CITI-IRA. That's CITI-IRA.
We're thinking of you're thinking.
Citibank, member FDIC.
The Morning Zoo.
So much for the future, got nothing left for me. Ooh.
restless through the city to find my fantasy. Look into your eyes and find you looking back at me.
Music Z100. Boy, what a mess we got around here this morning. I'm messing everything up. A little bit after 9 o'clock. Quit laughing, Bell. I'm just trying to do the best I can.
Hang in there.
It's been one of those mornings. Periods of rain today, and that's going to continue right through tomorrow, so I can safely say it's going to be a rotten day. Today's high 52, 42 right now, and rain on the Monday Morning Zoo.
All right, more tickets. See Jack Wagner on the way all day today from Z100. And I got a couple surprises for you Bon Jovi fans. Jack the Wack will announce the big winner tonight for that backstage bash. Fight time tonight. Burt Sugar. Is that his name, Sugar?
Yeah, Burt Sugar. He's from Ring Magazine, isn't he?
Yeah, all these big stars are making their picks. So, of course, you've seen this. You watched the special, didn't you, John?
Yes, I did. It was great yesterday.
On Marvin Hagler and...
Sugar Ray.
Jake LaMotta. One reason I like to be there is Jake LaMotta's wife's going to be there.
Vicky.
Vicky LaMotta, his ex-wife. One of his many ex-wives.
She of the Playboy centerfold there?
And she sticks it together at that age, doesn't she?
I guess you could put it that way.
She stays in pretty good shape. I admire her for that.
She certainly does.
I think she takes that Borga Tovine medicine. No, that Tova Borgine medicine.
Tova Borgnine.
There you go. Whatever it is, that's stuff that they sell.
You're just saying she gives the audience a lift, is what you're saying.
That's what it is.
Okay.
Anyway, Bert Sugar says he's picking Sugar Ray Leonard by decision.
Ooh, okay.
He also says, don't forget, though, I had Japan plus 7.5 in World War II.
Oh, God.
Yeah. Most of the...
Good for Bert.
most people are picking...
Hagler?
Hagler, except Thomas Hearns, the hitman, picks Sugar Ray Leonard.
Yeah, he said on that special yesterday that Leonard hits harder than Hagler. Although Tommy's been hit so many times, he may not
he forgot. talking about baseball. Got a nice prize for you if you'd like to have one of those Z100 Rascal dolls. These are cute for the kids. You gotta wait till you see it. You can't even imagine what they look like. Till you
it's
get
the
one.
Gruesomely cute new doll with the unforgettable sound by Matchbox Toys.
Thank you. That's a trivia question. Baseball trivia. Something will be different in every major league park today. What's the difference? There's something different in every major league park. There'll be a very subtle difference. Tell us what it is.
So it won't be the umpires. They're back, huh?
Yeah, they're back. We'll be doing without umpires. There's a very special difference.
Wow.
See if you know about that. That terrible story about Jim Baker. This Jessica Hahn thing. I don't know. Her attorney must...
Goes on and on.
Yep. Mm. Now she says that she got two for the price of one.
That's true.
I don't know whether I'd phrase it exactly that way, Scott.
My wife brought up an interesting point that many people... We were watching the news yesterday on CNN. What the heck was she doing... Now, remember, here's a very conservative woman, church woman, a virgin, she says, in a hotel room.
I believe her.
What was she doing in a hotel room by herself with this...
Well, she was with two preachers, Scott. I mean, that's not the kind of thing that she would...
She wanted clarification on some Bible passages.
Yeah. But she never has... You see, the thing about it is there was no rape involved. She's never even mentioned that. I mean, there was no forced participation.
Right.
I mean, Jim Baker's a wimp of a man. She's bigger than he is. She could have gotten away from him, you know?
Mm-hmm.
He'd been afraid to break his hair.
Well, wasn't she, quote, woozy from a little bit of the wine?
Didn't make any difference with a wimp like that. Just look at him. So now she says that she had sex with both of them. That Jim Fletcher guy got in on the action.
Mm-hmm.
Quite a rough little... starter kit there, isn't it?
Yeah.
Shoot, man. She claims that Fletcher was the one who gave her that wine.
Yeah.
And then disappeared when Baker entered the room in a white terry cloth swimsuit. Her testimony goes, Baker pulled me close, he unwrapped my dress and unsnapped the bra. He did it all.
Whoa.
And then after 90 minutes, Baker left and Fletcher reappeared, told her, well, it wouldn't be fair, would it, being that I made all the arrangements, then you left me out. Wow.
I want my commission.
Great pair of guys, boy, I'll tell you.
Yeah, there you go.
Lots of style and class.
Frickin' frack.
Sheesh.
The Hunch Brothers.
God.
Boy. Also in her statement, she says that the story includes Miss Hahn's claims, that, of course, that she was a virgin when she met Jim Baker. And also, she talks about Jim Baker's complaints about his wife.
Yes, I don't know whether you can
talk. You seen this yet,
yeah,
Nancy?
It's going to be very hard to discuss that.
Well, she says that,
Hi there. I'm afraid of this one,
this
really.
Is good. You're like, I noticed you're kind of like laying back on this one.
That's right.
He, Jim Baker was complaining about why he needed some outside help there. Said that Tammy was a big woman and that she couldn't satisfy him. So whatever that means, you have to kind of decipher that one for yourself. I think I've gone just about
maybe
far.
Maybe give him a call, right.
Yeah. Me the line.
She was too big. Yeah.
Smaller than your average bathroom, but a little larger than your average number two
pencil. All right. Shadow traffic is on Z100. Here's your friend Nancy Remy.
We're going to try to wind down a very busy morning. Still 20 to 25 minute delays inbound at the Holland and the Lincoln Tunnel. An average 30 minute backup at the inbound George Washington Bridge, southbound New Jersey Turnpike. Very heavy as you're making your way out on the Eastern Spur, and northbound's all tangled up out and from Interchange 12. Up and toward 15E, as a matter of fact, with the construction in the center lane of the Eastern Spur, the truck lanes are preferable. Eastbound 80 still packed in from Rockaway through Parsippany and slow for 2 miles both ways through the Patterson Construction Zone. Garden State Parkway jams up southbound from Clifton in toward eastbound Route 3, and northbound is heavier than normal from 117 toward the Raritan Toll, bumper to bumper from 131 right and beyond the Union Toll Plaza. Still looking at a 15-minute delay inbound to the Queens Midtown Tunnel, and the traffic southbound BQE has yet to improve. Extra heavy out and from Queens Boulevard toward the Williamsburg Bridge. We have a huge pothole at the ramp there, and it's slowing things down. Really only one lane open for business, and very slow traffic continuing westbound LIE out through both Suffolk and Nassau County and coming in through to the Elmhurst gas tanks. Westbound Northern State and Grand Central Parkway combination not much better. In the RE system, that's the Z100 Shadow Traffic and Transit Report.
Good morning. It's 42 drizzly degrees at 9:08. I'm Claire Stevens with a Z100 information update. The hundreds of Wayne, New Jersey residents who had to evacuate their homes because of the high floodwaters are hoping to be able to return by tonight. There is still a limited state of emergency in the Passaic River Basin area. A New York State trooper says there's only a remote chance, if any, of finding anyone who survived that 80-foot fall from a collapsing highway bridge over a creek up near Amsterdam. One body and one car have been recovered so far. Three other vehicles are still missing. It's going to be a funeral mass today for Peter and John Phillips in the same Massapequa church where Peter was married last week. Shortly after the ceremony, his limo was smashed by a car the police think may have been involved in a drag race. Peter's new bride has lost part of her leg. She and her sister are in critical condition and unaware of the deaths. About 50 protesters demonstrated yesterday outside the infertility clinic where Mary Beth Whitehead and the Stearns arranged the contract under which IBM was born. A new poll just completed shows that three-quarters of the Americans familiar with the case agreed with the judge who awarded custody of the little girl to the Stearns. New York Newsday says U.S. Attorney Rudolph Giuliani doesn't believe that Mayor Koch was aware of or involved in any way with the corruption that's rocked his administration, says there's no proof to the contrary. And by the way, Giuliani says his dream job would be to manage the New York Yankees. However, since George Steinbrenner hasn't called him yet, he says he's staying put, not looking for another job. Jack Kemp, however, wants a new job. The New York congressman plans to announce his candidacy for the White House today. Z100 Sports on yesterday's scoreboard. The Rangers were badly beaten by the Canadiens 8-2. The Devils lost to the Caps 6-5 in OT, and the Isles topped the Flyers 9-5. This afternoon, the Knicks host the Sixers and honor Dr. J. Yankees opening their season out in Detroit with Dennis Rasmussen on the mound against Jack Morris. And tonight, of course, the Hagler-Leonard fight out in Las Vegas. Our Z100 weather is looking dreadful. Periods of rain right through tomorrow, going up to about 52 degrees today and Tuesday, down near 40 overnight. It's currently 44 in the Meadowlands, 42 at Roosevelt Field, and it's also 42 at the Empire State Building at 910. I'm Claire Stevens for Z100.
I'm ready for prime time.
But it's
prime time ready for me.
People Magazine calls Max Headroom more daring and dazzling than anything on the air. It's wicked, fast, funny, and sophisticated, says Associated Press. And USA Today says Max holds us in its spell and that this series realizes the full potential of television.
Make room for Headroom. Max Headroom.
Tomorrow night, right after moonlighting, on WABC TV Channel 7 at 10 p.m.
WHTZ Newark, New York City.
This lady prefers a gentleman with style and flair, the kind that any girl would love to meet. He's so good looking and oh so debonair. With him, she has the whole world at her feet. Tom McCann, I'm giving you my name. We're in step together. I'm so glad I came.
Introducing the fabulous new Marilyn Monroe collection of shoes exclusively from Tom McCann. Shoes with style, flair, and a reflection of one of America's most loved stars.
Tom McCann cares the way a lady looks and feels. Next to Tom McCann, the others are all just heels. Next to Tom McCann, the others are all just heels.
Nobody beats the wind.
Nobody beats the wind.
New York's only total home entertainment center is celebrating the grand reopening of their 3rd Avenue and 153rd Street store in the Bronx. There'll be free gifts, plus the most unbeatable prices on every TV, VCR, personal, portable, stereo, rack system, record, tape, and CD. Everything, all under one roof. It's a total home entertainment center. The Wiz on 3rd Avenue at 153rd Street in the Bronx is like all Wiz stores, unbeatable. Grand reopening sale going on now at all 19 Wiz stores. Nobody beats the Wiz.
Nobody beats the Wiz.
Nobody.